And you have to begin with tawheed. فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه شهادة لا إله إلا الله. The first thing you should invite them to is the shahada of لا إله إلا الله. They tell you Allah is the creator, Allah is the... We all know that. The kuffar knew that. Where is tawheed al-uluhiyya? When their big sheikh, the one who authored some of their books, used to go at the grave site of some of the dead people and wait for wahi and inspiration from dead people. Their big sheikh, I forgot his name now, the one who, Zakaria Idris, Zakaria, something, Elias, the one who invented Jama'at Tabligh, then he used to sit at the grave and cover his head and wait to receive inspiration from a dead man in the grave. This is shirk, ya. This is the leader of the group. That's number one. So that idea is an innovation. Secondly, the book Fada'il A'mal, Fada'il Sadaqat, Tabligh Nisab are not good. They have some good material, but the books are not authentic. I've read them with my own eyes, four eyes. Well, back then I only had two before I started wearing glasses. The books have bad information. They teach you the wrong aqidah. They are Ash'ari in their aqidah, Sufi in their madhab, according to Tariqah, Naqshbandiyah, and whatever, the list goes on. So the books which they use are not reliable. Number three, anyone gives a bayan. For 6 years he wasn't praying. They went to his house, gave him da'wah. The first day he comes to the masjid, the second day he's speaking to the people. The Prophet ﷺ said, you don't know, ya akhi, you yourself.
أأمنتم من في السماء أن يخسف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور أم أمنتم من في السماء أن يرسل عليكم حاصبا فستعلمون كيف نذير
There is only one incident of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in which the Prophet asked a slave girl, where is Allah? And she pointed to the heaven. Where is Allah? Because your aqidah is so important. Without your aqidah, nothing is acceptable. And hence, in aqidah, the most important thing is your belief in Allah. So what do you believe in Allah? Where is Allah? This is such a foolish question. This is an innovative, this is a bidah. Where is Allah? This is such a foolish question. This is an innovative, this is a bidah. Where is Allah? This is such a foolish question. This is an innovative, this is a bidah.
Weak narrations fabricate, I mentioned that. Aqidah issues, fada'il a'mal, fada'il sadaqat. Wallahi, these are not the kutub of Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. They're not the kutub of Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. They are Ash'ari Aqidah. Ash'ari Aqidah. That's very, very dangerous and very serious issue. If the Aqidah is bad, don't ask about your Salah and Siyam because everything else is going to be pretty much bad. The most important thing is our belief system. Is understanding La ilaha illallah. Part of understanding La ilaha illallah is understanding Al Asma wa Sifat. In the books that they use, besides the fabricated weak narrations, my Tablighi brothers, you also don't follow the Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, which you have to learn from the reliable sources. And then, of course, division and hatred. They are very nice people, but generally speaking, very nice, very kind, unless they see that you may be in opposition, in which case different colors will come. And I've experienced that myself. I was called Wahhabi, Albani, terrorist. I killed innocent people. Why? Because I told them after the salah that Allah is above the throne. Allah is above the throne. Big fitna in the masjid. Big fitna in the masjid. The kind brothers earlier became enemies. Why? Simply because we differed on issue of aqidah. He read Fada'al Sadaqat. Some boy said that Allah is on his right, Allah on his left, Allah is behind. I said, akhi, let me understand this. What do you mean Allah is on his right, Allah on his left? Are you suggesting Allah is everywhere? He said, yes. I said, Allah says, أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورِ. He said, huh? Then, خلاص, they realized that they're dealing with someone that they will not agree with them. The niceness went away. And then all kinds of names were used and everything. Say, brother, why you do this, man? Why you dividing the ummah? Leave alone this jama'ah. You want to give da'wah, Habibi? Give da'wah 24/7. Give da'wah whenever possible. I'm not telling you don't knock on people's doors and call them to salah. But before salah, call them to Allah. Call them to tawheed. Make sure, if he knew Allah, you think he would leave alone salah?
And you have to begin with tawheed. فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه شهادة لا إله إلا الله. The first thing you should invite them to is the شهادة of لا إله إلا الله. They tell you Allah is the creator, Allah is the... We all know that. The kuffar knew that. Where is Tawheed al-Uluhiyya? When their big sheikh, the one who authored some of their books, used to go at the gravesite of some of the dead people and wait for wahi and inspiration from dead people. Their big sheikh, I forgot his name now, the one who... Zakaria Idris, Zakaria, something, Elias, the one who invented Jama'at Tabligh, then he used to sit at the grave and cover his head and wait to receive inspiration from a dead man in the grave. This is shirk, yeah. This is the leader of the group.